All right, 6.3, it's called elimination. We're going to eliminate something to find x and y. Again, we're trying to find the point where these two graphs cross. So if we just add straight down, do you see how these are going to cancel? And when you do that, 2 plus 3 is 5x. And then you have equals negative 5 and 25 is 20. That's pretty cool, because you add straight down and bam, you get rid of a variable. I can now solve for x. If I divide by 5, I got x equals 4. Okay, what does that mean? Well, we're looking for x and y. So now all we do is choose one of these equations, and I'm going to plug that in it. I'm just going to choose the top one. I just chose the first equation, and I'm going to take this, since it's x, and take it right here and plug it right there. I'm going to take the 4, plug it right there. So when I do that, I have 2x plus 5y equals negative 5. Again, 4 goes in right there, so we put 4 right there for x. And now I'm going to solve this. 2 times 4 is 8. Rewrite everything else. And then I want y by itself, so I'm going to minus this 8 over. That's gone. So you have 5y equals negative 13. And our second number isn't very pretty, but it's still doable, because if we divide by 5, you get y equals negative 13 over 5. Now, it's a fraction. That's okay. My final answer, well, isn't it x and then y? X is 4. Y is, well, that would be negative 2 and 3 fifths. Or you can leave it as negative 13 over 5. That is your answer. Elimination is pretty cool. It's pretty quick. But it can be a little bit more difficult at points. Because if you look right here, could I subtract, could I add down and cancel? No. So what you have to do is you have to take and multiply one of these equations so that you can cancel something. And watch this. What if I multiply this equation to get rid of that x? It's a 3x. How do you make this into a negative 3 so it cancels? Well, could I multiply it all by negative 3? Could I multiply this whole thing by negative 3, both sides? Yeah. Watch. When you multiply both sides by negative 3, you end up with negative 3x minus 3y plus 15. So I multiplied the negative 3 through. And then the top is still 3x plus 4y equals 2. So that's the first one. This is the second one after I multiply by negative 3. You say we can cancel? Now, how did I choose negative 3? Well, I looked at the x and the y and I thought, what's a small number I can multiply and change, let's see, the y's. If I want to cancel it, it needs to be a negative 3 to cancel with the positive 3. And so I multiplied everything by the negative 3. Anywho, let's solve this. You add straight down, that's gone. This right here leaves you y. This right here leaves you 17. Cool. Now, we got half of it. Which of these two equations looks easier to plug 17 in? I would say the second one. Isn't that pretty simple? Isn't x plus y equals negative 5 a simple equation? Can I take this bad boy and plug it right there for y? I plug that in for y, so replace y with 17. And then solve this. Real simple solving. Minus 17, x equals negative 22. So my answer is a coordinate, negative 22 and 17. That's where these two graphs cross. Now, the last one. Do they cancel? No. Now, could I just multiply this to get a negative 5? Could I multiply one of these to... You can't just multiply one of them, can you, and cancel? You actually have to multiply both. Now, there's multiple options, but watch what I'm going to do. I'm going to multiply each of these. We got to choose a letter. Either we could get rid of the y's or get rid of the x's. Aren't the y's smaller?
Yeah.
So, if what do 2 and 3, what number can we make with the 2 and the 3? 6, right? 2 times 3 is 6. So watch this. What if I multiply this 2 by 3? Watch what's going to happen. I'm going to multiply this by 3. So 3 times this is negative 15x. 3 times this is 6y. 3 times this is 96. Now, I have a 6y now. How do I make a 3y into a negative 6y so they cancel? I want this 3 to become a negative 6, so I'm going to multiply this by negative 2. Negative 2 times 2 is negative 4x. Negative 2 times 3 is minus 6y. And negative 2 times 20, negative 2 times 10 is negative 20. Can we cancel now?
Yes.
Now, for some of you, you're like, how the heck did I find these numbers? Look right here. Look at the 2. You saw I just put it right there? See the 3? I just put it right there. Kind of put it in the opposite spots. Now, why did I make one negative? Because if I didn't make one negative, would they cancel?
No.
Don't one of these have to be negative for it to cancel? Yeah. See right here? In order for them to cancel, one was negative, one was positive. Here, one was positive, one was negative. One has to be negative, one has to be positive. So I just chose one of them to be a negative. You just kind of take this, put it there. Anywho, we can now cancel. This gives us negative 19x. And this, ooh, that looks like a negative 76. Oh, it's positive 76, correct? Now, that's kind of ugly. We divide by negative 19. But does it actually work out nicely? It's actually negative 4, I think, right? Oh, at first it's kind of like, ooh, that's scary looking. Okay, I got half of it. Now, which of these two equations to begin with would be easiest, kind of smaller? Would you say the second one? The second one, the 2x plus 3y equals 10. Can I take this bad boy and plug it right there for the x? So now I have 2 times x, which is negative 4, plus the 3y equals 10. Could I solve this? Yeah. Can I solve this new equation? Yeah, that's negative 8 plus 3y equals 10. I can get y now. To get y by itself, I have to add the 8 over to cancel it. So I have 3y equals 18, it looks like. Then to get rid of this 3, I divide it off. Got to do it to both sides. 18 divided by 3 is... 6. So my answer. Well, my answer is a coordinate. And which is x? X is negative 4. And y is 6. Negative 4, 6 is a coordinate where these two graphs cross.